We have never operated all three of those floodways at the same time, never. This year, we think we're going to do that. We already know we're doing Bonnie Carey. They've already operated the Birds Point New Madrid, and with the predicted flows, there's no reason to expect we would not operate Morganza, but that decision has not been made yet. But that's just the historic nature of this event that's coming at us. To show you, without that design, the Mississippi River tributaries, this is the Vicksburg gauge elevation here. This is the, This is the area that would be flooded if you did not have the Mississippi River tributaries project in place. That's, you know, the whole Mississippi Valley here. That is significant. Looks like 27 type flooding. So without the project that's out there now, that's what you'd be faced with. Again, just want to show you some of these figures so you can see where we're coming from. Not going to give you all the gauges, you know, like we normally do for the governor, just on the next 3 days projection. But this is big picture where we're going. Cairo hit an all-time high. The 61 is with the floodway up there operating. The elevation there would have been closer to 64 point something if they did not operate that floodway up there, and that would have been additional stress on the levees from that extra 4 foot of water. Significant. As you come down, you can see Memphis, Arkansas, City, Greenville, they're not going to hit the all-time records, but they're pretty close. If you get further down the river, Vicksburg, we're going to hit a new record. You go down to Natchez, a new record. So again, unprecedented amounts of water and a historic nature here. Given all that, you live behind a levee, there is nothing that guarantees you're going to be safe. There is always some level of risk if you're living behind a levee somewhere, and that's part of what people want everybody to understand as we go through with our inundation map showing you, trying to explain to everybody so you're aware, and the governor's office mentioned it, and I've heard the governor mention it, you need to make your own decisions, but we want you to understand the risk that's out there and the possibilities and where we think things are going. So I'm going to transition now into what we see coming and let you see that information. But again, there's always some level of risk. Even if you think you know where the water's going, we show you something, it can change. Our modeling and our forecast are based on the anticipated rainfall over the next 5 to 10 days. We start getting different rain in the next 5 to 10 days, things are going to change. But based on the amount of water we got coming down the river, we know we have a significant, unprecedented event coming. So this is our stretch of the Mississippi River throughout the Vicksburg District here in the mainline Mississippi River levees. The good news here is, as part of levee certification, we have gone through over the last year or so and started the evaluation process with engineers out on the ground walking the mainline levees from up just south of Tunica all the way down to Vicksburg. We have good data on what those levees look like, and those levees are in good shape. We're going to be able to maintain 3 feet of freeboard, the length of those levees, and the freeboard is water above where we expect it to crest at. So at that 57.5 on the Vicksburg crest, we're going to have 3 feet of levee above that as you run it up the levee. So overtopping and all of that is not a concern at the given forecast. And 3 feet's the minimum. We've got more in most places in Mississippi. As you come down, the only place we've identified in that whole stretch is down at Buckshoot Bio, which is in the Eagle Lake area, and people have heard about Eagle Lake, and I'll address that in a few slides. But that is our only concern on the mainline Mississippi levees. But there is going to be some impact to the water coming down the levees, and I'll hit the ports real quick. Rosedale, based on the water they've got coming, most of their impact is just going to be from high water and the availability of being able to get in and out of the port for commercial uses. They're going to be, the water's going to come up and disrupt them, but it'll mainly be from the commerce side. And the port directors on top of it, they've got the one industry out there that's going to be close. And whatever precautions they take, that could delay their operation and all that, but they'll make a business decision in conjunction with the port on how they're going to deal with that. When you come down to Greenville, they're going to get water up in some of their buildings and facilities. So they're going to have a little more disruption and whatever it takes them to prepare for it, and then the time to recover from those preparations. So they're going to be impacted. It'll be more than just from the river commerce aspect of it. When you get down to the port of Vicksburg, their big impact is going to be access to the port itself. 61, the business area going in there, is going to go underwater at some portion, which is going to cause traffic to be rerouted, and that will impact the port operations. There's a couple locations at the port where they're actually getting, when you're out onto the port, getting into the road, they may have trouble getting into their facilities, but their facilities themselves will be pretty good shape. All those facilities, warehouses in Vicksburg are high. It's just getting into them. With that, I want to transition down into Buckshoot and explain to you what we're doing down there. I think most people here know this area, but Buckshoot's an old oxbow, or Eagle Lake is an old oxbow of the Mississippi. As you come down here, you got the mainline levee, and then we're going to transition into the backwater levee. So you come down mainline, then you go into the backwater levee here. In this area up in here, we have had sand boils over the years. In that area, in the high water event back in 2008, we identified some. We started working on an engineering solution to protect that levee, to give it a greater level of protection and reduce the risk at that location. Those plans, we're planning on doing a construction contract this fall, depending on when we got the funding, either in the August, September timeframe or October. But we had a fix on the shelf. And just want to show you real quick, for people who aren't familiar with the sand boil, kind of what we're talking about. Within the levees, and there are thousands of sand boils in our area, and it's kind of a normal way. Water is going to flow through the ground. You get groundwater in your yard. This is kind of how water works. But water is going to want to go from the high side to the low side. So if we've got a levee that's holding it back, water wants to get over to here to equalize the pressure from one side to another. This water is just migrating underneath the levees all over the place. And in certain places, when you start getting a channel like this where it all gets strung together, it's going to pop up in a location, and you end up with that groundwater coming up, and that's what we call the sand boil. Sand boils are not a big problem as long as it's just water moving from one location to another. When you start having a concern about sand boils is when the water coming up here has a lot of material in it, and you don't know where that material is coming from. It could just be coming from the ground down here. It could be coming from over here, just moving along with the water, and it comes up. It could also be from up here in the levee. So that's why we pay a lot of attention to sand boils. We get engineers out there. We monitor the flow. We look at the clarity, see what material's in it. Standard flood fighting techniques is you take sandbags and put pressure on the ground. That will keep the material from moving with the water. You raise it up a little bit so you have more elevation. If you got water up here and water down here, it wants to equalize, so you raise it up on the low side, you don't have as much water wanting to travel. So you try to relieve that pressure. And again, for sand boils, you can have a sand boil. A guy asked me yesterday over in Louisiana, how far away could it be? And we identified one that's almost like a mile and a half from the levee. And it was a sand boil, water coming from the Mississippi River over underneath all that and traveling a mile and a half. That's okay. We get concerned when you get sand boils that are pretty close to the toe of the levee, because you're going from there to there, most likely you're impacting that levee. So we want our sand boils to be farther away is better. Close is not as good. But again, we've got techniques to take care of that. What we're doing at Buckshoot is we went in, and we've got approximately 2 acres there where we had numerous sand boils. They developed in 2008. We had the high water mark, or high water event about 2 months ago. We had more sand boils come up. We got information. We've got a new high water mark coming down. We decided we need to do something now and not wait, since it's going to be at an unprecedented record here. So we went in those 2 acres, cleared it off. We're backfilling it with sand to get it on top of those sand boils, and we're going to cap it with clay, and that'll give us a pretty good layer instead of doing the sandbags. And this is just one big sand boil. We're raising the elevation up on top of getting pressure on it to keep material from moving through that water. In addition to that, at Eagle Lake, to equalize the pressure from the Mississippi River to the Eagle Lake side, with the forecast we had, we were just about a 30-foot difference in elevation from where you had the river on this side of the levee to the ground over here at Buckshoot Bio. So that's, you know, 29 feet or so. That's a big difference in elevation. So in addition just to building up the ground where we had the sand boils out on the Buckshoot side, we're increasing the lake level up to 90 feet. And that will go a long ways to equalizing that pressure and causing the water not to want to travel as much. And that was just required a deviation from the water control plan at Eagle Lake. I don't think I've got a graphic that shows it, but that keeps all the water within the banks of Eagle Lake. It's not going out anywhere else in the delta. It stays all right there at Eagle Lake. It's not the water that's impacting 465 going underwater anywhere else. That is a very localized fix. There's just a picture of where we're at. 2 weeks ago, all that was swampy-looking trees. Okay, that's the main line, Mississippi, and what we're doing to deal with it. I'll cover the backwater area now. We've got the backwater levee. You can see it's quite an extensive levee system running up north of Yazoo City here into the delta. Along that levee, we've identified low spots. The authorized grade for that levee is elevation 107. We've gone out there with the local levee boards and our surveyors. We've identified where the low spots are. They range from, you know, 1 inch down to about 11 inches. So we're no more than a foot under the elevation we're supposed to be at. And that includes like the cattle grates you got out there. We got to pull those out, put sandbags in, get those raised back up. That includes those dips that are out there. Normal things, if you've been out on the levees, you got them all over the place. So we're taking care of that. The Corps is taking care of Highway 61 going towards the river. Peter Nimrod and the Mississippi Levee Board is taking care of the levee going 61 up into the delta. At the area we expect to have overtopping of the levee, we're going to go in and put down bisqueen, poly, vinyl to cover that area. So as you get water overtopping a levee somewhere, you would like it to be uniform. So as that elevation's at 107 the whole length of the way, that gives you the maximum protection for when the water's going to overtop. And then as it overtops, we want it flowing over the plastic so we don't eat into the levee, and that gives us a level of protection there. And we'll do that from the riverside, come over the top of the levee, and run it down into where the water's going to go. And that will give us a level of protection, again, reducing that risk of, you know, when you have the flooding event occur. With that said, before we even get to backwater flooding, you've got the Mississippi River that's rising. And this is an inundation map. It just shows you where water from the Mississippi is. I drove up here from Vicksburg this morning, come across the, you see water out there, 465's underwater. You know, where's that water coming from? That's the Mississippi River that's out there. So the river itself just impacts quite a bit of area. And again, this is based on our crest, which is the current prediction is on 57.5 feet on the 20th of May. So a lot of water is going to be up there, backed up all the way, you know, towards Yazoo City. This is the impact to that, where, you know, the number of acres impacted, the crops. What I want to do now is kind of show you the roads we've identified, and we've been working with the Department of Transportation and other folks, emergency responders, to get them this information. We get, at the Corps, we do big picture mapping and modeling. We've been working with the locals now to get the exact date on road elevations and all that so we can plot it, but they're working with us so we can get that data out there and make it available to people. Been good coordination so far with the state. It's just how quickly can you get it done. We change our elevations and all of a sudden everybody wants a day-by-day blow. What we can give you right now is at crest elevation, here's where it's going to go. But our accuracy, you know, where exactly that one spot is it goes under, we're not there to give you that foot, but we're working on that to provide that information. But along the Highway 61 here coming out of Vicksburg, you come down the hill at Redwood, you can see this area is going to be underwater.